Some of you may or may not remember that fantastic anime from 2016 about a sport where girls use their boobs and butts to knock people out of a ring. I remember this show because this show broke the minds of all feminists who are into anime. Keijo is a very simple anime. All the characters are girls, and they play this sport. In this fictional sport, they're on a floating platform surrounded by water, and they have to knock the other girls off using only their boobs and butts. Using the very things that make these girls female, they must fight each other. And people could not fathom such a show. Oh boy, did Adam tell me stories about how his college handled this show. He told me people who talked about this show in his college, they spoke of it as if it was a video of a puppy being murdered. And what did Kotaku have to say about it? Girls fight with their butts and boobs in this wretched new anime. You know, for an article complaining a lot about the show, you got a lot of gifts. I don't care that it's well animated. I don't care that the women have discernible personalities. No cookies for you. It is beside the point that Keijo was previously a manga. It could have died in obscurity. It is a thing that exists in a world that is increasingly horrible and full of deplorable things. What I don't understand is why, despite cultural differences, a lot of American anime fans see Keijo and laugh it off, unmoved that in this show, women are valued at the sum total of their body parts. Why? Why are they taking a show where girls fight with their boobs and butts not seriously? It's very interesting to me hearing people who haven't even watched the show talk about this show as if it is like the ultimate disgrace. Like this is where anime is going, where they only see girls as objects and all they have is fan service so guys can jerk off to it. You know, it's like borderline porn. But if you actually watch the show, you probably wouldn't think that. In fact, I would say it's probably impossible for a man to jerk off while watching Keijo because it's hard to jerk off when you're laughing so hard. Although I'm sure the Joker has probably managed to do it. Keijo is a parody. The entire show is a joke. They know that the plot is ridiculous and they take full advantage of a ridiculous plot. This show is so funny. Keijo parodies so many different animes in this show when these girls are fighting. Like, the main character can displace the air with her butt. There's another girl who has the spirit of Cerberus in her butt, and she literally just bends over and the dog just shoots her across the platform. Are you a One Piece fan? Would you like to see butt gaddling? How about titty hypnosis, the forbidden technique? It blows my mind that anyone could possibly take this show seriously as a threat to womanhood. Look, do I deny that there's a lot of fan service in anime? No. And I don't think the creator of Keijo would deny that there's a lot of fan service in anime. I think that he knows there's a lot of fan service in anime and decided to make a joke out of it instead of ignoring it. And in making this joke, he made one of the funniest animes that exists to this day. He's making fun of the fan service, he's making fun of the fighting, but also even if you detach the satire, it's still fairly good. The characters are genuinely fun and interesting. They're well-made characters. Even within this very jokey universe, they're very likable and you do actually root for them. At the end of the day, the guy is just a good writer. But of course, I'm a woman, so therefore I'm betraying my own gender by enjoying this anime. And you know, it kind of goes back to what I've said before about how any bad idea can be made good if you have a good writer behind it. If you have a good team behind it, you can take bad ideas and mold them into something really enjoyable for viewers to watch. Keijo is a very good example of that. But you know, a lot of people are really turned off by this show because of the plot and because of all these people who just have decided to hate anything that has to do with female sexuality, anything that has fan service in it, even if the fan service is a joke, a satire. It doesn't matter, sexy girls are bad. Anything that has sexy girls in it must be bad. Therefore, we must all hate this show collectively. I mean, all you're doing at the end is you're judging something before you've even watched it. And you're limiting the amount of shows that you can enjoy. Because unless you give something a try, you don't actually know if you'll enjoy it or not. For most of my life, I never really checked out dirty humor because I just always assumed that I would not enjoy dirty humor. But there are actually, you know, some books with dirty humor in it that I enjoyed, and like I said, I enjoyed Keijo. Sometimes you gotta step out of your comfort zone and try something new. And of course, you know, Keijo did have some inspiration in the creation of Orgasm Girl and how that's going to be executed. I have my own comic that's gonna be dirty jokes and poking fun at sexuality. And I'm sure that's going to be met with the same premature conception of what it actually is. I'm sure people are already gonna decide, no, I wouldn't like that book because I don't like dirty humor. And you know, if you're not interested, I wouldn't force you to look into it any further. I wouldn't force you to watch Keijo. But I do think that it's worth a try. It's a funny show. And I think that Orgasm Girl is gonna be a funny series too. And I think that people will enjoy it. But I totally understand that some people just aren't willing to step out of the comfort zone. Some people are going to have a premature bias that'll keep them from watching the show. Really, I would encourage people to, one, don't be afraid to step out of your comfort zone every once in a while. Two, lighten up a little bit. Not everything is meant to be taken super seriously. Three, don't judge something before you've given it a chance. I'm still waiting for Keijo season 2. Now, have you personally watched this show? And what did you think of it? Tell me down below in the comments. Do you agree with me that people took this show way too seriously and that they were very judgmental of it? Do you agree with me that the show is very goofy, very funny? Have you not seen this show and are you interested in checking it out? Are you more interested in Orgasm Girl, which will be coming out soon? Well, good for you. You can sign up for the mailing list down below in the description. Regardless of what you think, thank you guys for watching. Remember to like the video. I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Program restart.